Hi, greetings from Om Namah Shiva. You are welcome to my channel. Water Knowledge Hub. So today we are going to discuss about the wall, gate wall, functions, its related course. Let us see. There are so many walls, but let us discuss one wall in one video, its function, its materials, its parts, and symbol of the same. So today is our part is gate wall. Gate wall. In simple words, I will explain you. Try to understand. If any doubt, you can write me a comment. A gate wall is having a straight flow. That means straight flow means it will enter from here. It is called upstream. Where the liquid is entered, that is called upstream of the wall, and where it is going, that is downstream of the wall. So straight, it will enter the upstream and it will go towards downstream. Full bore flow. So it's called straight flow and full bore flow. Now this position is open position. This is gate. The gate is open position. Now flowing. This figure, you can see this gate is closed. So no flow this side. Only flow is holding here because the valve is closed. Now let us know about the parts of the gate valve. Normally the system, a lock nut, lock washer, hand wheel, internally grub screw. This grub screw will drive the stem. Then you are rotating the valve, hand wheel, and the yoke. And packing gland, gland follower, and this is gland pusher. This is the packing. Okay? And this is gate. This is bonnet. This is body. This is seat. Is it clear? These walls are designed as per APA 6D. 6FA, APA 598, APA 600, APA 602. You can read these specifications. Okay? This is ASME, ANSI, B16.34 walls, flange, threaded, welding end. AP16.5, flanges and flange fittings. ASME ANSI B16.10, face to face dimensions. Okay. B16.11, forged fittings, socket welding and threaded. B16.25, butt welding ends. ASME B16.47, large diameter steel flanges. This specification for flanges larger than 24 inches replaces MSS SP 44 and APA 605 with the designations of series A, MSS SP 44, and series B, APA 605. This is replacing. So whenever they ask in-plane piping, refinery piping, in-plane piping in the sense, B31.3 chemical plant and petroleum plant refinery piping, which is within the boundary. Whenever you are designing and you have to use these codes and standards. Now, B31.4, liquid petroleum transportation piping system, that is cross-country pipelines. This cross-country pipelines, whenever you are using cross-country pipelines, you have to API 6D, we have discussed earlier. API 60, API 6FA, these are the API 60 specifies the pipeline walls. 6FA, fire thrust walls. API 598, wall inspection testing. Any gate wall during the course of maintenance, preventive maintenance, once it is coming for maintenance to lap the seat or gate, and replacing the packings. Okay, packings okay. When you are replacing or repairing these internals, it should be retested. Upstream test, downstream test, and combination test as per API 598. So API 600 is gate walls, flanged and butt weld ends, bolted pressure seal bonnets. This bonnets also screw type is there, okay, and flange type bonnet is there. So seals also are available. AP602 compact steel gate walls, flanged, threaded, welding, and extended body ends. Let us learn first the symbols. If you see the symbols, this is gate wall symbol. Rest of the walls we will discuss later. Today only we will discuss about the gate wall. This gate wall is, it may be flanged, welded, butt weld or socket weld or screwed. This is pipeline. This is a wall handle. So handle direction is parallel to the pipe. That means you should ensure during installation this wall handle is parallel to pipe. Okay. That is open position. Gate wall. If the perpendicular means you have to install the handle in that side because operational purpose. You see this threaded wall, flanged wall, butt weld wall, and socket weld wall, wafer type wall, lug type wall. These gate walls are widely used for all types of applications and are suitable both above ground and underground installations. When the operating system walls them, the gate moves up or downwards on the threaded parts of the stem. Gate walls are often use the well minimum pressure loss and a free bore is needed. Free bore is a free flow. Gate wall works by inserting a rectangular gate or wedge to the path of a flowing fluid. They are operated by a threaded stem. Connects the actuator, generally a hand wheel or motor, to the stem of the gate. When fully open, a gate wall has no obstruction in the flow path, and so has a very low pressure drop. These are the applicable codes as we discussed just now. See, this is OS and Y walls used in firefighting lines. NRS means non-rising stem. OSNY means outside stem and yoke. These walls normally used in firefighting system. Okay. Any doubts? You can talk to me. You can call me. You can write to me. Thank you very much. Please subscribe, share my channel. and write your comments. Okay, my friends, thank you very much. Have a wonderful day.